A good way to start this second video on facial bones is with two bones that we've already looked at, however, never officially introduced, and those are the palatine bones and vomer. Let's start with palatine bones. Recall that your hard palate is made up mostly by the palatine process. That's part of the maxilla. The posterior one-third of the hard palate is made up of the palatine bones. There's actually two bones here that fuse together. We saw vomer in the previous video as well. Vomer makes up the inferior portion of the nasal septum. Do you remember what the superior portion of the nasal septum is? A few videos back, we saw that that is called the perpendicular plate, and it belongs to the ethmoid bone. Vomer does not belong to the ethmoid bone. It's its own independent facial bone. We've seen this bone, or pair of bones, already as well, but let's officially introduce the inferior nasal conchae, plural, with an E at the end. That's because it's paired. You have one on each side. So there's your nasal septum again, but recall that the lower half of the nasal septum is not the ethmoid bone, which it says here. The inferior nasal conchae are their own independent bones. The middle nasal conchae, and what you can't see further up or further superior, are the superior nasal conchae. Well, they are part of the ethmoid bone. So here's a recap of the nasal cavity. I've done this before, but now that we've covered all the bones, let's actually review it one more time. This is looking into the nasal cavity of your skull. There's a nasal septum, which divides the left nose from the right nose. And then you have these ridges on either side. And remember the ones up here that you can't really see, right? These ridges are there to warm the air as you breathe in. Well, let's make an imaginary line. I'm just going to make a dotted imaginary line. We'll call it the ethmoid line. That means the superior portion of the nasal septum belongs to the ethmoid bone. The inferior portion belongs to, or doesn't belong to any bone. They're independent bones. So here's your perpendicular plate of the ethmoid bone. There's your middle nasal concha. And superior nasal concha belongs to the ethmoid bone. Your inferior nasal concha, since it's below this line, is its own bone. This is vomer, which is its own bone, separate from the perpendicular plate of the ethmoid bone. We have paranasal sinuses inside at least some of our facial and cranial bones. These are spaces within the bone that act to make your skull a little lighter and also produce the sound of your voice because they're resonating chambers for your vocal cords. Here are the four bones in the skull where we find sinuses. So these are important to know. Frontal bone, sphenoid bone, ethmoid, and maxillary bones. Let's see an image of those. So here we go. We should know these four bones as containing sinuses. The largest ones would be the maxillary sinuses. And next to that, after that, would be the frontal sinuses and the frontal bone. The sphenoid and ethmoid sinuses and air cells, you can substitute sinus for that. We can see in this view, the ethmoid bone is located anterior to the sphenoid bone. So these would be the ethmoid sinuses or air cells. That would be between the eyes. And further posterior, we have a sphenoid sinus. And the last bone in the entire skull is not a cranial bone. It's not a facial bone. It's not even in the skull. We really have nowhere to put it because of its key characteristic right here. The hyoid bone, which is found in your neck here, is the only bone in the entire skeleton. Out of all 206 bones, this is the only bone that does not articulate with another bone in the skeleton. So all other bones articulate or form a joint or connect to another bone, but not the hyoid bone. It's on its own, just hanging out here in the neck. It's a base for the tongue. It's an attachment point for a lot of muscles and ligaments in your cervical area, but it does not articulate with any other bone in the body.